As planet Earth is heating up, a growing number of farmers are pulling up stakes and moving north, chasing cooler temperatures their crops need for growth. Ben Tracy has a report on how climate change is changing where and what we plant.
The most unusual thing about Joe Franklin's 78-acre citrus farm is that it really shouldn't be here.
When I first started with it, people couldn't believe me when I told them it was grown right here in Georgia. They didn't believe me. Oh, no, you can't grow that here.
But Franklin now has 12,000 trees growing fruit in the middle of Georgia.
Grapefruit, Meyer lemons, tangos, gold nuggets, satsumas, Georgia kisses, bingos.
You'd normally expect to find hundreds of miles south in Florida.
So I'm not going to find a Georgia peach anywhere on this land?
No, afraid not. One of the main things that drove my decision to plant them was the fact that it is so much warmer now than it was 30 years ago, 40 years ago. I know when I was growing up, golly, in October, you always had a couple of frosts. In November, you usually had a freeze. That doesn't happen anymore.
Did you think of that as climate change, or did you just say something's different here?
No, I thought of it as climate change. And it's happening. I mean, there's no doubt about it.
A month of rainless days and temperature above 100.
Farmers have always dealt with the whims of Mother Nature. But now climate change is changing what they can grow and where they can grow it.
Like, everyone knows, of course, there's global warming, but then what does it mean? So
Hemanshu Gupta is the CEO of San Francisco-based startup Climate AI. Their platform uses machine learning to identify climate risks for food companies and farmers. The stakes are high. Worldwide, it's estimated crop yields could decline up to 30% by the year 2050, as the planet warms and climate change fuels more severe drought and flooding.
A lot of crops, not just in the U.S., but also in Africa, India, are already seeing the impacts of climate change. If we move into the future, these areas will have a significant shift.
Gupta showed us how the cranberries on our Thanksgiving tables will likely have to be grown significantly further north in the coming decades.
It's going to be riskier in a lot of places to grow certain crops in the future, but this is helping mitigate some of that risk.
Absolutely. And using that, you can tailor your recommendations for the food companies or seed companies or for farmers.
Dramatic shifts are already happening. There's now coffee from California and fine wines from England. But while warmer temperatures may benefit some crops, they can devastate others. In Georgia, the state's famed peach trees require significant winter chill in order to bloom come spring.
So this is one of your weather stations?
Yes, we have 89 stations across the state.
Pam Knox is an agricultural climatologist at the University of Georgia. She says winters here have warmed on average more than 3.5 degrees since the 1800s, enough to put many varieties of peaches at risk. Researchers are racing to develop new warmer weather varieties to take their place.
As warming continues, should we expect crops to kind of migrate north in some fashion, things that needed to be further south in the past?
There will be some migration. There's some limitations to that. The kind of soil you have, whether you have access to irrigation, what you've grown traditionally, because if you're a peach producer, you're probably not going to suddenly switch to cattle.
Joe Franklin's bet is paying off, but he knows a changing climate likely means more losers than winners.
For this to be working here means it's probably not working so well for somebody further south.
Right, exactly.
Do you think about those folks?
I do, and I feel for them. And it's a gamble, it's a risk you take, you know. It's one of them things.